The king sits in Dunfermline toon, a-drinking at the wine. And he has called for the finest skipper in Fife and all the land. Then hooted Spock, an old Carlo, stood by the king's a-knee. Said Patrick Spens is the strongest sailor that ever sailed the sea. The king has scribbled a brave letter and signed with his ain hand and sent it to young Patrick Spens a-walking on Leith sands. To Norroa, to Norroa, to Norroa o'er the fame. The king's doctor on Norroa, 'tis ye mun bring her hame. When he look at the letter on, a muckle laugh gave he, but ere he'd done the reading aught, the tears blinded his ee. Oh, why is it done this fell deed, and told the king of me? Although it were my ain faither, and ill deeth may he dee. There hath na been in Norroa a week but barely three, when all the lords of Norroa tid up and Spock's a-free. These hootland Scots waste our king's doubt and swallow our queen's fee. Weary for the tongue that Spock sick a muckle lee. How can this be, said Sir Patrick Spens, I pray ye tell to me. The bows of my ship are wrought with gold, and there's 12 kissed the white bonny. Talk tent, my guid men all, and mind ye be weel forn, for come it wind or come it hail, our queed ship sails the morn. Then hooted Spock, the weatherman, I fear we'll all be drowned. For I saw the new moon late yestreen, with the old moon in her arms. They hadna sailed aboon an hour but and a half, when the lift grew late and the wind blew hitch, and the ship, it was a wreck. Oh, where will I get a bonny lad to take my steer in hand while I climb up the high topmast to see if I can spy land? He had not gone a step a step but barely ain. When the bows of our Gweedly ship did brock, and the South Sea it come in. Oh, laith, laith were our Gweed Scotslerts to what their cork eel shoon, but lang ere the ploy was done, they wat their hats aboon. Oh, lang, lang will the ladies sit with their fans until their hands before they see Sir Patrick Spens come sailing to the land. Half over to Aberdour, where the sea's so wide and deep. It's there lies young Sir Patrick Spens with the Scots lads at his feet.